What is industrial organizational psychology? Hi, welcome to the channel. If you're new here, I'm Erika, a Master's of Organizational Psychology graduate with over 4 years of experience in workplace well-being, research, and consulting. In this video, I'm going to break down exactly what IOPsych is, what IOPsychs actually do, and see whether this career path is right for you. If you're interested in psychology but you're not sure what career path to take, IOPsychology is a really good potential career path option that might be available to you. Alright, so let's just break down what industrial organizational psychology is. If you search what industrial organizational psychology is online, pretty much most resources will say that it's some sort of scientific study of human behavior in the workplace. The way I like to understand industrial organizational psychology is by using this sort of framework over here. You really want to think about an organization as a holistic system that's made up of different moving parts. We know that organizations are complex, they have individuals, they have teams, leaders, and then you have all the organizational policies and culture that surrounds that. Industrial organizational psychology is really thinking about the holistic picture and the system and seeing ways in which we can apply psychological principles and theories and research to optimize the workplace. And so obviously with the definition, we have the industrial side, but we also have the organizational side. The industrial side focuses on things like hiring, job training, and performance management, for example. These are all the different things that involve personality assessments, thinking about the recruitment process, and more of the HR side of things. And then we have the organizational side. This is the side that I'm really interested in, and the organizational side consists of broader, higher level things like culture, leadership, team dynamics, well-being, and what really makes people motivated to come to work. If you're really after a technical definition, here's a technical definition that I could find online, but I really like to think about it as the systems and framework approach because it helps to kind of put it into a little bit more context. And I feel like it's really common when explaining to other people what I do for a job, it can be kind of difficult, but I do my best, and I basically say that it's psychology in the workplace, but ultimately with the goal of wanting people to work better and be healthier. I feel like a really important part of defining IOPsychology is also distinguishing between what IOPsychology isn't. I feel like this is a really common misconception that people think IOPsychology is the same as human resources. And while we do work closely with HR teams, given that the work is closely related, and you'll often find organizational psychology professionals working with teams in fields like organizational development, but it's not HR in the sense that organizational psychology tends to draw a little bit more on research, what the evidence says, and best practice in industry. I feel like another important thing to address in industrial organizational psychology is understanding what IOPsychs really do in the workplace. I feel like this information can be a little difficult to find online, or if you're lucky, you're able to contact someone on LinkedIn and see what's going on in terms of their role and their career. But I'm here to let you know what IOPsychs do. I just want to preface that I'm not a registered industrial organizational psychologist, but I did do my master's in industrial organizational psychology, and so I do have a background in it. And currently I'm working as an organizational psychology consultant, but I can't technically say I'm a psychologist because I haven't been registered yet. Anyways, IOPsychs. They do all sorts of different things in the workplace, and they have so many different career options related to industrial organizational psychology. So the possibilities are truly endless. You could go into all of these different areas here, and yeah, that's one of the main reasons as to why I really like organizational psychology. If you're into business, if you're into psychology, you'll definitely find an area that you'll want to specialize in. And so some of the different things that IOPsychs might do in their everyday jobs might be things like looking at an organizational strategy to develop well-being in their organizations and in their employees. And so this might mean consulting with an organization on what is best practice, what does the research say on how we can develop a well-being strategy, how can we build our people up and implement systems? How can we build initiatives to really hone in and own the well-being strategy? So that's definitely one side of things, looking into strategy. Another really common field that organizational psychologists work in is organizational development, but more specifically, looking into developing people and leaders. There are so many different resources out there when it comes to leadership development, employee development as well. So these things look like developing trainings, facilitating them, and so presenting these training sessions on how to build professional leadership skills and how to run teams effectively. We also have another really common area looking into organizational change and change management. That's a really common one. We know that change is constant, inevitable, and so having organizational psychologists come into organizations, understand the change process, and see how the change process can be improved to really reduce the uncertainty and the negative impacts that it has in an organization. That's something that they can specialize in. But again, as I said, there are so many different career pathways that you could go into specifically using the lens of organizational psychology. If we think of organizational psychology at a higher level, so really kind of zooming out from the picture, a lot of organizational psychologists work in different fields. And so I personally, I'm not a registered org psych, but I personally work in a private consulting firm. It's a well-being, workplace well-being company. But I also know a lot of org psychs who are working in the public industry. They also have their own sort of consultancies and own, you know, businesses. I've seen a lot of org psychs in the field of academia and research, which is also an area that I'm particularly interested in. And so you can really go into different sectors and industries as well, which makes it a really great place to start if you're an undergraduate or someone doing a postgrad degree, because you can start to kind of think about what sort of areas that you might want to go into. And so how do you know if org psych is for you? Org psych might be for you if you're naturally really curious about human behavior. Obviously, a lot of people are interested in psychology. I too was really, really interested in psychology as an undergrad student, but I was also interested in business. I was interested in understanding how we can manage businesses, how we can manage people effectively. And so it was really about drawing those two sides and two topics together to come together to look into org psych. You would also really enjoy organizational psychology if you're someone who really seeks variety in their roles. I don't want to be cliche, but no day is the same as an org psych. You are constantly working with different clients and different organizations, faced with different problems and unique problems too. And so it's really fun if you're interested in problem solving, coming up with different ideas, initiatives, but also coming from a research background. Again, you'd also really enjoy organizational psychology if you're into research and have a sort of statistical analysis lens to things. You don't have to be a professional in running stats analyses, although that would be an added benefit, but if you're into research and you like to know what works, what doesn't, what best practices, org psych would be really, really up your alley. All right, well, if you enjoyed this video, let me know in the comments below. And if you have any questions about organizational psychology generally, I'm really happy to make a video and answer any questions that you might have. I also really enjoy making YouTube shorts and TikTok videos about my day-to-day life and workday my lives as an org psych consultant working here in New Zealand. And so feel free to watch those videos and check me follow. If you enjoy this video, please like this video. Please help me out. No, I'm just kidding. I really want to make useful videos that talk about industrial organizational psychology, because I feel like this type of content is lacking a little bit on YouTube, and this is exactly what I sort of wanted to come across when I was getting into org psych, and so I'll be your org psych girl. And yeah, if you want to know a little bit more about org psych, subscribe to this channel, and I'll delve into all things or psych, what I do in my daily life, and I'll break down how to get into this career option as well. And yeah, I have a specific lens in terms of working in New Zealand and studying in New Zealand, and so this might be extra useful for you if you're in New Zealand yourselves, but I'm hoping to create some videos that are a little bit more high level and can be applied globally as well. Alright, well, thanks for watching my very first YouTube video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!